In this video, we'll take a look at coefficient alpha and how to run that in SPSS. A coefficient alpha is also known as Cronbach's alpha, and it's one way to estimate the reliability of an instrument. And really, when we're using coefficient alpha, we're estimating the internal consistency reliability. And in this example, we're going to go ahead and take a look at a very commonly used scale, the Satisfaction with Life scale, which was created by Diener et al. And on the scale, there's 5 questions, and you can see those here. In most ways, my life is close to my ideal, the conditions of my life are excellent, and so on. And what happens here is the respondents read each question, and they answer on the following 7-point Likert scale, where they answer strongly disagree, disagree, slightly disagree, and so on. So they choose one of those responses, and they get a 1 if they answer strongly disagree, a 2 for disagree, and, for example, a 7 for strongly agree. All of you have probably taken a scale before, a Likert scale. Many of you have taken several of them, I'm sure. So what we want to do, once again, is find the reliability in SPSS as measured by coefficient alpha. And it's important to keep in mind, if there's 5 different questions, and each person responds on a 1 to 7 scale, then the total possible score for an individual could be as low as 5. That is, if they got a 1 on each question or that strongly disagree, they would have a score of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, adding up those values, all the way to 35 if they answered 7 on every single question. So it's good to keep that in mind when you're running these analyses in SPSS to make sure that you never see any responses that are outside of those ranges. If you do, like you saw 3 or you saw 38, that's an indication that something's wrong. Something's going on there, and we want to take a look at that. There's a miskeyed value or what have you. And in this example, we have 80 respondents who took the scale, and I've already entered those into SPSS in this hypothetical example. But the results are fairly consistent with what we find in the literature using the scale. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Okay, here I've got the data, and we have 5 different variables: satisfaction with life scale, item 1, item 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then, as I said before, we have the responses for 80 total people. All right, so let's go ahead and run the analysis. So we want to go to Analyze, and then Scale, and then select Reliability Analysis. And then here we have our 5 items. I'm going to press the Shift key, select the last one, and that grabs them all. Move them over to the Items box. Notice under Model, the default is Alpha, and that's what we want. And I'll go ahead and give it a label. I'll call it Satisfaction with Life Scale. And then let's go to Statistics. And then here under Descriptives 4, I'll go ahead and select all of these, and we'll talk about that in a minute. And then everything else I'll just leave as is. Go ahead and click Continue, and then click OK. And here we get our results. And you can see case processing summary. We had 80 valid cases, 0 were excluded. So that means everybody had meaningful values that were used in the estimation of the reliability coefficient here. Next table, reliability statistics. This is the one we really are looking for, first and foremost, although we'll discuss the other tables as well, and they are important. But this is where our alpha is at, and it's given under Cronbach's alpha. And we have a reliability rounding of 2 decimal places of 0.88. And that's really very good. The highest possible reliability coefficient is 1.0, but 0.88 is really quite good. The highest ones I see, without being a massively developed intelligence test or what have you, is 0.91, 0.92, 0.93, sometimes a little higher, but that's the absolute best I typically see, and 0.88 is right up there. So I would consider the reliability, as measured by Cronbach's alpha, for the satisfaction with life scale to be very good. And that's actually what we find in practice when the scale is used as well. Okay, so next let's look at the item statistics.